Yo, what up, saying? Today I'm back, got tatted again, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, man, today basically what I'm gonna be doing is I'm gonna be making a UK rap type beat for someone like Nines, Meeks, Fredo, someone like that. So yeah, man, let's jump straight into it. Right, so I'm going to start off by breaking down the melody I made. So this is what it sounds like put together. And then vocals come in. Right, so starting off, I've got this chord progression just made with a bell. This is what it sounds like. So yeah, man, it's basically just a simple chord progression. Basically goes down, then up again, and then in the second four bars, it's got the middle notes inverted to get a different sound. So for the effects I've got on the piano, I've got an EQ just simply taking out 50 hertz of the bass, and then quite a lot of reverb actually. It's got quite a long delay, decay. Done a low cut as well to get rid of that low reverb, and then also added a RC20 to give it a vinyl effect. Right, and then next I added this. It's sort of like a bell. It just sits in the background of the melody. It just adds another layer to the melody, and this is what it sounds like. As you can see, it's got like a sort of swinging effect, so it gives the melody some more rhythm. And the effects I have on there is just a simple reverb. Next, I added this this lead. It also just sits in the background of the melody, just to add another a layer to it. And then I changed the notes up. And then the effects I added onto that was a reverb cutting out most of the low end, and only really leaving the mid to high end. And also a reverb. Yeah. And I cut out some of the low as well, quite a lot of decay. After that, I added a simple bass. It just literally follows the bass notes of the piano. You know what I'm saying? It's just a bass, and then there's no effects on there. Yeah, no effects on the bass. I then added a vocal for some variation in the melody. It also gives it that rap vibe. You know, it's always got to have a vocal, well, most of the time anyway. Do you know what I'm saying? And this is what that sounds like. It's just from Arcade. Oh, hang on. Do you know what I'm saying? It fits the vibe perfectly. And then the effects I've got on there, I've got a decimal, which is like a resampler, bit crusher, whatever you want to call it. It gives it sort of like an underwater effect. It's good for vocals. And like this rap vibe. I've also got the EQ. Right, and then finally, what I like to add sometimes is just a perk in the background or like a rim or something. And then you put a lot of reverb on it and stuff. It just gives it a nice effect, like emotional effect to the beat, to the melody, sorry. This is what that sounds like. Do you know what I'm saying? That just repeats through. And the effects I have on there are some more decimal, quite a lot of it as well. Because you want it in the background of the melody, like proper in the background. I have an EQ phone effect on it as well to take away all the frequencies. And then also a lot of reverb. Do you know what I'm saying? So yeah, man, basically that's the melody. Let's get onto the drums. Right, so now we're onto the drums. I'm going to quickly play it for you. So you know what it sounds like overall, and then I'm gonna break each part down. So this is the intro. Building the energy. Yeah, man, as you can see, it's quite bouncy, and that's perfect for the type of beat that we're going for. Right, so starting off, I added the kick. As you can see, there's quite a lot of space between each one, apart from at the end of each four bars, and this is just to build the energy at the end of it to transition into the next four bars, basically. And this is what this sounds like. So yeah, man, that's basically just the kick. And then moving on to the rim, it's basically just a simple rap pattern. And then at the end of the four bars, add the extra rim to add the energy again at the end of the four bars. Next, I did the hat. So I've done a quite bouncy pattern. It's like you hit two at a time and then add a couple filler notes, like a roll every now and then. It's got quite a bouncy feel to it. And also I played with the velocities a little bit. You want to do this to add more bounce, basically. And this is what all three of them sound like together. And as you can hear, I've added a bit of reverb onto the hi-hats just to give it a quite cool effect. Like, it gives it a lot more, sounds a lot more full, do you know what I'm saying? And then also added reverb to the rim. It just fills the sort of gaps between each note, each sound. So yeah, man. And then basically all else I did was a crash and then also a reverse open hat at the end of each two bars. Simple, shut and turn. So anyway, yeah, man, thank you a lot for watching. I'll be back next week with another tutorial. Put in the comments down below what tutorials you want me to make. Give me some ideas, shut and turn. Anyway, yeah, thank you for watching. See you in the next video.